Peace Road 2015 is a project in which global citizens, united in heart, pray for the unification of Korea and world peace and work together. The Peace Road seeks to unite all people, transcending the barriers of race, nationality, religion, and culture. The Peace Road project was launched based on the International Peace Highway project proposed by Reverend Sun Myung-moon and Mrs. Hak-ja Han-moon at the 10th International Conference on the Unity of Sciences held in 1981 in Seoul. In keeping with the Peace Road project, the first steps to building the Korea-Japan undersea tunnel have already been undertaken, and progress toward the construction of the Bering Strait Tunnel that connects the North American continent and Russia is being made, heralding the opening of the Age of Peace in the Global Village. In 2013, the Peace Road Project carried out the Korea-Japan 3,800-kilometer nationwide bicycle tour, through which cyclists traverse the nations of Korea and Japan for the unification of Korea and the creation of a World Peace Park in Korea's DMZ. The project pooled together the passionate will of the people for the unification of South and North Korea. In the following year, 2014, 14 nations held the Peace Bike Grand Tour for Unification, including Korea, Japan, the United States, China, Russia, Israel, and Taiwan, with their long-cherished dream of world peace. And in 2015, the World Bike Project was expanded to become the fastest-growing peace project in the world. Participants in 121 nations cycled under the banner of Peace Road, writing a new chapter in history. The Peace Road Tour began on May 30, 2015, from the Cape of Good Hope in the Republic of South Africa, and simultaneously from Santiago in Chile in South America. Then, linking across 121 nations of the world, participants traveled in the direction of the Korean Peninsula to Seoul in the south and Pyongyang in the north. This year marks the 70th anniversary of the liberation of Korea and 70 years of separation. For this reason, the traces left behind by the Peace Road Project seem more precious than ever before. People around the world cheered the energetic beginning of Peace Road 2015.
Desde el Salón de Honor del Palacio Municipal de Santiago de Chile, mandamos un saludo para el Camino de la Paz de las dos Coreas, del Norte y del Sur. ¡Chao!
Bueno, Gina Torres, como diputada nacional, cuarta secretaria de la Cámara de Diputados, quiero realmente apoyar a este hermoso proyecto que está realizando, Camino de Paz.
Peace Road 2015 was carried out over 93 days on different courses, one starting out from the Cape of Good Hope in the Republic of South Africa, passing through Europe and the Middle East to reach Korea, and the other starting out from Santiago in Chile and passing through North America and Japan to arrive at the Korean Peninsula. The Peace Road represents a journey for peace. Colombian National TV even aired a television program in which they broadcast interviews from the Peace Road rally in Bogota, Colombia, and with representatives of the Universal Peace Federation.
Well, we have to know that all over the world, people are struggling for make a peace in their country. So I think that through this peace award, we're gonna participate from unify all the world, all country in the round world.
自分の父親が日本人で母親が韓国人なんですけれども、それで日本からつないできたその道を通して繋いできたものを韓国にも連結できたらなと思って、はい、参加させていただきました。
통일과 평화로 가는 이 운동에 꼭 한번 참여해보고 싶다는 그런 마음에서 이번 기회에 참여를 했습니다.
피스라도!
Across the continent of Africa, the voices praying for the unification of the divided Korean Peninsula and peace resounded in 33 nations, including Cameroon, Benin, Togo, Congo, and Nigeria. In the Middle East, where conflict is ongoing, peace events were held in Israel and Lebanon, transcending religion and race. In Europe, bicycle tours were held in 34 locations in 31 nations, including Poland, the Czech Republic, Spain, and Finland. And in 11 nations in Asia, including Nepal, China, and the Philippines. 11 nations in South America, including Chile, Bolivia, and Peru, and 14 nations in Central America, including Panama, Costa Rica, Nicaragua, and El Salvador, participated in the Journey of Peace. In North America, beginning with the global launching ceremony held in Las Vegas on May 30th, cyclists crossed the United States between July 18th and August 6th, passing through Los Angeles, San Francisco, and San Diego, finally arriving at Washington, D.C., thus bringing the nationwide tour to a successful conclusion. The Japanese team traversed a distance of 15,000 kilometers on bicycles in 1 month, starting out from the northernmost part of Japan, Nosatsu Misaki in Hokkaido, passing through the southernmost city of Okinawa, finally reaching the port city of Shimonoseki, and ultimately arriving at the port of Busan on August 21st. The Korea tour teams from each country set out from the Nakdong River and passed through Changyang, Goryeong, Daegu, and Daejeon, and assembled at Gwanghwamun Plaza in Seoul, thus successfully concluding a 3,180-kilometer nationwide tour of Korea in 8 days.
回っていけるそんな時があるのがすごいなと思って参加しました.
Peace Road is connected everyone, every human in our earth, and give us freedom to go anywhere and live harmony and peace.
Peace Road가 평화통일까지 이어졌으면 좋겠습니다. 화이팅!
평화로 세상을 연결하자. Peace Road 화이팅!
The 2015 International Symposium for Korea Reunification and World Peace was held in the main conference room at the Korea National Assembly Building, where 500 leaders from every field and Peace Road cyclists attended. The National Assembly Research Organization Unification Future Forum and Unification Korea Federation co-hosted this event. Prime Minister Hwang Kyo-an sent a congratulatory telegram, and the Minister of Unification, the Minister of Transport, and the Minister of Culture, Sports and Tourism gave congratulatory remarks. This was followed by welcoming remarks from Cho Myung-chul, the co-representative of the Reunification Preparatory Committee, and Son Byung-ho, the co-representative of Peace Road Korea. Leonid Kravchuk, a former president of Ukraine, Jung Kap-yoon, the Korean National Assembly vice president, and Ju Ho-young, a member of the Korean National Assembly, gave congratulatory remarks.
"한반도 통일과 세계 평화를 기원하며 지난 5월 30일 미국 라스베이거스에서 출발식을 열고 시작한 피스로드 2015 세계 대장정이 오늘 서울 광화문 광장에서 종주 완료 기념식을 열고 마무리되었습니다. 세계 120개 나라에서 30여만 명이 참가해 3만 킬로미터를 종주하며 세계 평화를 기원한 이번 행진은 90일간의 대장정을 거친 뒤 서울에 도착하면서 끝났습니다.
Finally, the Peace Road 2015 that was held in 121 countries for 93 days has celebrated its completion at the Seoul Gwanghwamun Plaza August 27th. The event was sponsored by the Presidential Advisory Committee to prepare for Korean unification, the Ministry of Government Administration and Home Affairs, the Ministry of Unification, and the Ministry of Culture, Sports and Tourism.
세계 평화와 남북 통일의 그날까지 피스로드 행사를 통일과 평화를 위한 지구촌 대축제로 만들어 나갔으면 합니다.
The participants in 121 nations performed a DMZ truce line cutting performance and sang Uri Sowan in hopes for a peaceful unification for Korea, which is the only divided nation in the world.
Peace Road는 인종과 국경의 장벽을 넘어 하나님 아래 하나의 가족을 실현하기 위한 것입니다. Let's go together. One world, one Korea.
Peace Road 2015, the global peace project, through which the hearts of 300,000 people from 121 nations united across the world, added its warmth to the summer of the global village. Under Peace Road 2015, conflicts and disputes among nations, peoples, and religions lost their meaning. It created moments where the people's hope for world peace could be brought together as one. Communication between nations must be reconnected. Peace and prosperity in the global village must be achieved. The grand tour traversing the world for the sake of peace and unification, which is the greatest task our global village must complete, will never come to an end until the day on which peace and unification are realized.